As an annual publication, the War Report, along with the Rule of Law in Armed Conflict platform, is the only independent global classification of armed conflict under international law. The Academy has been running the project since 2012, and the 2016 edition has shown that 49 situations of armed violence have amounted as armed conflict under international humanitarian law and international criminal law. Out of these conflicts, the vast majority are of a non-international character. That means that these are conflicts opposing states and armed non-state actors or armed non-state actors between themselves. This edition also highlights key legal and political development in selected armed conflicts. Syria, but also Nagorno-Karabakh, Western Sahara, the military occupation of Cyprus by Turkey, and selected non-international armed conflict like Afghanistan, Colombia, Egypt, Iraq, Mali, South Sudan, Turkey, Ukraine, and Yemen. The War Report not only classifies the situation, but also gives the historical background of this conflict, describes the parties to the conflict, and gives information about the possible allegations of war crimes, prosecutions, and investigations. Some of these conflicts regularly make the headlines, such as the one in Syria, the one in Iraq. Other conflicts are totally forgotten, the conflict in Western Sahara, in Nagorno-Karabakh, in Mali, or in South Sudan. The analysis drawn from the War Report shows two trends. The first trend is the increasing impact on the civilians, which are often trapped in cities, either during long sieges or because they are trapped in battlefields that take place within cities. And the other trend is the increasing involvement of foreign states in certain conflict and the increasing impact of international coalitions in certain situations. The War Report can be a very useful tool for any practitioners, lawyers, judges, persons who work in international organizations, who work in non-governmental organizations, but also, of course, students. It is a useful tool not only because it describes the facts which are relevant for each of these conflicts, but also because it classifies the situation, and as such it gives information about the legal framework applicable to each of these conflicts, including whether or not international humanitarian law applies to the situation.